For every generation, it has started with the call to serve. Discovering the purpose and the belonging earned with the title. Learning to dig deep and push through adversity together. Defending our nation and its people. It is a life of great worth and reward. But Marines are never really finished serving. Their commitment comes full circle, visible in communities across our country. This is Semper Fidelis, always faithful, always Marine, marking a path for the next generation.
Hi, I'm Kevin Harrington, an original shark from Shark Tank. Protect your ankles with Prevent Sprain socks.
In sports, we wear all types of equipment to protect ourselves from injury. We use helmets, mouth guards, shoulder pads, chest protectors, and knee, elbow, and shin pads for protection and prevention. One of the most important yet neglected parts of the body are the ankles.
Research shows that more than 30% of all sports injuries are ankle-related, and 62% of all ankle sprains happen during practice and training. Just think about it. Very few sports can be played with an ankle injury, and it can take 1 to 3 weeks to heal, sometimes months to get back to full strength and mobility. Preventing an injury is key in any sport and applies to any job where you're on your feet all day as well.
Prevent Sprain socks were scientifically designed and engineered for support, stability, and performance.
Stay active with PreventSprainSocks.com.
What's up, sports fans? This is Bobby Allen, broadcaster for the Varsity Sports Network, and I'm here to tell you about an incredible opportunity that your business can advertise with us on the only 24/7 high school sports network. We can base any package around your budget or advertising needs, and it is unparalleled in comparison to other opportunities out there. We cover every inch of the Sunshine State with 16 channels of varsity sports coverage. Come join us in supporting these student athletes, local schools, and the local communities. Email us today at sports@varsitysportsnetwork.org or call the number below on your screen to find out how we can help you market and promote your business in the best possible way. Again, I'm Bobby Allen with the Varsity Sports Network, and we are the home of high school sports in Florida.
We're often asked, what's more important in retirement, having a great plan or working with a great advisor? The answer is that both are vitally important to your retirement success. Retirement planning is not just a one and done. Even the best plans will need to be adjusted. That's exactly why you need an experienced partner to guide you on your journey. How confident are you? Call us today for a second opinion.
Searching for meaning in a relentless world, always connected, but somehow alone, trapped by illusion. We offer another path, where the battle to belong begins. Awakened by a calling, united by the cause you fight for, no one can take away what it means to be among the few, the proud, the Marines.
Marijuana can impair your ability to drive, and that affects much more than just you. Drive baked, get busted.
In sports, we wear all types of equipment to protect ourselves from injury. One of the most important yet neglected parts of the body are the ankles.
Research shows that more than 30% of all sports injuries are ankle-related. Preventing an injury is key in any sport and applies to any job where you're on your feet all day as well.
Prevent Sprain socks were scientifically designed and engineered for support, stability, and performance.
Stay active with PreventSprainSocks.com.
Welcome back to the Varsity Sports Network. Once again, I'm Madison Little, joined today by Michael Trulio, who came down from the Daytona Channel to spend some time with us here on VSN Orlando. We appreciate you coming down, and I'm excited that you're here, Michael.
Yeah, I mean, getting up at 6 in the morning, driving across the state, all in the service of good sports broadcasting. I love it.
And we just saw some good sport as well, where Sebring and Bell Creek went head-to-head for third place, Sebring coming out on top in two sets. Reminder that in this tournament, they are playing best out of three, where usually in the regular volleyball season, high school level, they play best out of five. But now we're gearing up for the battle for gold, Michael.
We've got the Southland Christian Flames from Kissimmee and the Central Point White Tigers. As we mentioned in our little pregame show we did, only one loss between both of these teams. That Central Point lost their opening game to Lake Nona. They've been undefeated since then. Southland Christian has not really been challenged at all season. They've been sweeping aside teams. It's the old adage of the unstoppable force against the immovable object. One of these teams is going to have to settle for the silver here.
Yeah, we talked about it a little bit earlier. Like you said, there's a lot of talent on these teams. Just by watching them warm up and gear up for this game, you see the amount of talent, height that these teams have compared to our last matchup between Sebring and Bell Creek. They're taller, they're faster, they jump higher, and I'm excited to watch these teams go head-to-head right now.
I was very impressed with Central Point watching them warm up, especially with number 8, Maureen Reyes. She's going to be the primary setter, and her setting accuracy is impeccable. Back sets, forward sets, cross court, just amazing all around, and we are getting ready for action here.
The teams in their little huddles getting ready to hype each other up, get ready for this set, and decide who's going to come out on top today.
Southland in the red, white, and black. They'll be nearer to the camera. And Central Point in the neon green and navy blue. They'll be on the far side. Southland libero in black. Central Point libero in that navy blue. And we are just about to get it away. Something that strikes me immediately before you even start playing volleyball is how much taller the front line for Central Point looks compared to Southland.
Yeah, and it's definitely something to say because we're looking at them, they're further away. So usually with that perception, you would imagine the Southland team would look taller, but even from across court, Central Point definitely wins in the height aspect of things. But like we said earlier, Southland has been unfazable so far in their season, so this should be interesting. They have a lot of talent on this Southland team, but also a lot of talent on the Central Point team, so it's going to be an interesting one. And I think Central Point will start us off with service going to number 8, Marion Reyes, who you just talked about, setter for this Central Point team.
She will get us underway. Here we go. Ball is served and away we go. Southland with a opening point victory as Reyes tried to save it off the kill. And it is Yaelis Perez Canedas for Southland Christian who gets the scoring underway.
That was a really good pronunciation, and I would like to apologize if we mispronounce any names on any of these rosters moving forward.
There's the set by Reyes, tipped over. It's going to be the libero to set it up, tipped over the net and down, and Reyes with the save. Central Point going back across, dug out by Figueroa, and down for Southland Christian, 2-0 early. Valerie Rodriguez, the senior, with the point.
You can already tell just in those first 2 points how much faster this match will be compared to our last. And I think that's why we see these two teams here. They're fast. They're talking. You can hear them talking from up here, and it's just going to be a different match, I think.
Back set by Reyes. Tip into the net by Phoebe Reyes. Reyes again. Over the net for Linares. Whistle and a stoppage of play. Southland's going to get the point for a net infraction.
That gives them a 3-point lead right off the bat, coming out strong for the Flames today.
It's kind of hard from where we are to see the lead official. kind of outside of our field of view down to the left, as that's a service ace for Southland, 4-0. And if you had asked me to predict the score at the end of 4 points, this would not have been it.
No, I agree. Definitely, like I said, a lot of talent on this Southland team, though. Head coach Alex Rivera told me that the half of this team is actually new. They have a new team, a new system, and they're adapting well to it, and the girls are buying in.
Central point on the board with the hammer by KTL Alonzo. It was Maureen Reyes setting it up. Southland on the attack. It comes back to Aquino, and she can't get it over. And Central Point with two straight are back in this one, 4-2, Southland. The libero, Ramos gets it, tapped over. And Yarelis Perez-Canedas with her second point of the match. She went right at Ketiel Alonzo on the left block, well, I guess right block from their angle, and she could not corral it.
Another thing I think we should point out about this Central Point team is that it's a roster filled with seniors. Every single player on the court for them is a senior, and they are all, Michael, going to play at the next level.
That's incredible. Cross-court set, down, and a point for Central Point. Darlenis Olivo, and that is the setting accuracy I was talking about in warm-ups from Maureen Reyes. That went fully across the face of the net and right in front of Darlenis Olivo to set it up. To the side, cross-court dug out by the libero Lopez, and another block at the net for Southland as they take a 6-3 lead.
One thing we didn't see in the last match that I'm seeing now is that Southland actually has quite a fan section up top right next to us, and they're into it.
Yeah, they've traveled from Kissimmee, and they are supporting their team. Another cross-court hammer shot by Darlenis Olivo. Caroms off of Figueroa and out. So Central Point keeping up here, down by two. Expect them to go that Reyes to Olivo connection a lot in this game. That is the primary modus operandi of their offense. Tough set. It only can be floated over. Reyes set. Olivo again. This time it's blocked away in front by Kia Bonanno. I've been impressed early on with the frontline play for Southland. They don't have a lot of height, but they are getting a lot of verticality on their jumps.
Yeah, definitely a lot of strength in their legs, able to get them up over that net. And I think when you look at this team, they might not be your stereotypical volleyball athletic looking type, but they definitely all look very athletic.
That time Olivo got it down, Ramos could not control. And Central Point continues to be down 2-7-5. Serving is Olivo. Goes all the way cross court. Here's the set by Rodriguez. It goes over the net. Excellent dig by Olivo. It's going to be a free ball, though, for Southland. Set by Rodriguez. Over the net. Tipped. Recovered once. Recovered twice. That was Olivo and Linares combining. It's going to be another free play for the Flames, though. Almost tipped over by Rodriguez. This time it's a free play. The libero handles it, and then Olivo, it's blocked away in front again. That was Phoebe Reyes trying to bring the power, but it was rejected at the point of attack, and it's 8-5 Flames.
That was impressive. Usually when you see those girls get up on the net like that and they're so close to the line, you 9 times out of 10 it's going to go out and the point would have gone to Central Point, but they were able to get that one down and in, giving them a point.
And I think that was an important change of pace on that last point for Central. They went with a drop shot. Everything's been power so far, but they go to the drop shot, they play it off speed a little bit and confuse the Southland defense. Ramos tipped over by Aquino. Long set, power down and power home for Darlenis Olivo. Back to route one for Central Point, and they get another score on the board.
And that was scary looking, Michael. That came fast.
You see in my notes, setting accuracy and power. There's the two notes I made watching Central Point warm up. Cross court pass to the back it goes. deflected and back to Olivo, and she can't finish the job. It was a nice save by Ana Maria Linares back towards the netting. But it is 9-7. So after an early flurry by Southland Christian, it's basically been point for point here the last 8 or so points. Again, the set by Reyes. Tapped over, dug out by Rodriguez. The libero plays it across. Aquino. Cross court, power down, blocked at the net. Alonso tried to bring it home, but Perez Canedas was there to meet it.
Central Point able to cut that lead to 1 point. Now we have a score of 9-8, Southland. I don't think they were going to get away that easy with the Central Point team.
Oh, no. I would expect this match to be close throughout as that kill attempt goes into the net from Aquino.
And that one ties it up, Michael. We have a score of 9-9 now.
Central Point has recovered from their early deficit. Quick set. Unable to be handled by Perez Canedas. And then a diving attempt by Bonanno on the back end is no good. We'll take a timeout. Central Point leads it 10-9. You're watching SSAC Volleyball on the Varsity Sports Network.
Are you in the market for the finest athletic apparel available? Check out theimperialpoint.com. Fully sublimated designs, top quality, made in the USA apparel for any team and any fan. Check them out today at theimperialpoint.com or give them a call at 800-801-4884. Imperial Point Apparel, made in the USA.
Welcome back once again to the Varsity Sports Network, live from the Wingstop broadcast booth here in Winter Haven, Florida, at the beautiful Advent Health Fieldhouse. Lots of volleyball going on, and right now we are watching the battle for gold in the blue division. Central Point leading for the first time, 10-9.
Barely, Aquino was able to get that over the net. Central Point with another chance. Alonso with a kill attempt that sent back where it came from, but out of bounds. And it is a 2-point lead for the ladies in neon green. Maureen Reyes, the primary setter, will serve. Diving to the ground is Bonanno. Kill attempt for Aquino, dug out by Olivo on the back line. And here is the power down the line from Cadiel Alonso.
She has a lot of power, a lot of height, and when she's able to get it over the net and hit that spot, it's unstoppable.
4-point run right now for the White Tigers. Easy ball, back set. Not ready for it was Linares. So it'll be a free play for Southland, but that ball goes well long from Figueroa, and it's a 5-point swing for the Tigers.
What a turn of events, Michael. We came out, Southland able to get the first 4 points, and I think Central Point kind of just got their stuff together, and now they able to take the lead.
We saw this in the last game with Bell Creek and Sebring. It was close early on, but then Sebring got their act together, made the necessary changes on the defensive side, and eventually took the win easily. I'm not saying that's what's going to happen here because Southland is tough competition. Set from Reyes. Cross court it goes, and powered down again by KTL Alonso. They have changed it up a little bit, with Alonso coming from the back line to hit that kill now instead of Darlenis Olivo, who was doing it early on in the game. But now we see Olivo rotating to the back. Maybe she will be who they're aiming for on the kills. Tough set handled by Aquino. And Vicky Aquino's kill attempt goes long. And the run continues for Central Point. Oh, no. They're going to say it was touched by the Tigers. So the run is over for Central Point. Near side set, powered down by Phoebe Reyes, and the Tigers are right back on the serve.
One thing I noticed about this Central Point team is that every single one of these girls are able to play and be effective in all positions.
We haven't really seen nice little improvisation from both sides. Olivo almost got that one easy at the net. Olivo digs it out, back set, left side, cross court, and down for Ana Maria Linares. And something that has impressed me about Central Point early on is they don't get out of system and out of rotation very often. Everything is very controlled, where you see Southland trying to kind of chasing the game a little bit.
Yeah, but like I said earlier, this is a young Southland team. But with that, we will take a break with the girls, and we will come back right here on the Varsity Sports Network.
We're often asked, what's more important in retirement, having a great plan or working with a great advisor? The answer is that both are vitally important to your retirement success. Retirement planning is not just a one and done. Even the best plans will need to be adjusted. That's exactly why you need an experienced partner to guide you on your journey. How confident are you? Call us today for a second opinion.
And welcome back to the Wingstop broadcast booth, brought to you by Varsity Sports Network. If you're looking for some custom uniforms or fan wear, look no further than Imperial Point. Imperial Point is the best when it comes to uniforms, and a lot of the volleyball teams go to them. So shout out Imperial Point for keeping us alive and keeping these girls well-dressed.
A little bit of a scramble there out of the timeout. Southland a chance to get into system here. Cross court block to the net, but not far enough. And it will be Southland Christian to get the point. 18-11 right now. The White Tigers of Central Point lead Southland. We're in set one of the gold medal game here at the SSAC Volleyball Invitational for 2022. Reyes to Olivo. And we've seen that one time and again here in this first set. 19-11 now for the Tigers. We have some statistics here for Southland. Topping the team in hitting percentage is Zaraliz Perez Carinas. We've heard her name a little bit. That was an error for Maureen Reyes. I think that's the first error she's made, as that one glances off her forearms and out. Southland will have the play. And here she is right now, Yaralis Perez Cadenas, serving. Reyes back set. Power off the block and out. And Central Point moves to within five of taking the opening set.
They'll give her a little break right now and check in their libero for her. That is... her hair is covering her jersey.
Maria Jose Lopez is the libero for Central Point. There's a service ace for the Tigers. But Perez Carinas leads this Southland team in almost all statistical categories. Kills per set, hitting percentage, and total blocks. Best defensive player is Saelis Ramos with 1.5 digs per set. She is their libero, so it makes sense. And Madison, this was a very close game early on, and it has gotten out of hand very fast.
Yeah,
21-13.
Turn of events. Southland came out able to get the first four in this set. And then very quickly it became a tight-knit game, and now Central Point has pulled away for the 21-13 lead.
Dug out by Ramos, but the set from Rodriguez goes into the net. And it is 4 points for Central Point from victory in this first set now. Remember, just a first to two, best of three in this tournament. It'll be Darlenis or Olivo to serve. Back corner it goes, dug out by Aquino on the set and down. Olivo with the defensive play again. A spinning ball dug out by Ramos. Over the block and over everything from Figueroa. And Central Point inches closer to that first set win. Olivo continues to serve, Ramos the dig. Long set, and it's just pushed over by Figueroa, and down for Central Point. Set point for the White Tigers.
Watch the way she serves the ball. It's almost as if, it's like a knuckleball in baseball, if you will. She's just able to send it, and then it just kind of drops.
That's very impressive. It is dug out by Aquino. Aquino gets it back. It's tipped off the block, into rotation, back set, tipped to the floor, and the first set is done. Phoebe Reyes with the final kill, and center point comes from behind to whitewash Southland in that first set, 25-13. It's 1-0 Southland. They're one set away from taking this one home. We'll be back with the second set on the Varsity Sports Network.
For every generation, it has started with the call to serve. Discovering the purpose and the belonging earned with the title. Learning to dig deep and push through adversity together. Defending our nation and its people. It is a life of great worth and reward. But Marines are never really finished serving. Their commitment comes full circle, visible in communities across our country. This is Semper Fidelis, always faithful, always Marine, marking a path for the next generation.
Marijuana can impair your ability to drive, and that affects much more than just you. Drive baked, get busted.
And welcome back to the Varsity Sports Network, live from the Wingstop broadcast booth. I'm Madison Little, joined by Michael Trulio. We just saw Central Point take that first set 25-13 over the Southland Christian Flames. But we still have one to go, potentially two. Michael, what did you see from that Central Point team that was impressive last set?
Well, I saw them get rattled early. I think they were not expecting to be hit in the mouth like they did by Southland. The Flames came out and got four straight points, but they got it together. What I love about Central Point is the consistency of their offensive system. Is that in? No, it is not. It is barely out, so the first point goes to Central. Well, I love their offensive consistency. Every time the set is in the right place, the pass is in the right place, the kill goes down the line, it's not straight at a defender. And it makes it very difficult for Southland defensively, even if they are able to dig it out, as a little bit of a mishit from Perez there, as gives his second point to Central. Even if they are able to dig it out, Southland, they're out of system because the ball's careening every which way, and they're having to scramble to recover.
Yeah, we're off to a bit of a different start than we were last set. Like you said, Southland able to get the first four, and now Central Point coming out strong, leading 2-0 early on.
There's a block at the net from Southland. Central Point recovers down the middle off the top of the net. Recovered by Rodriguez. Set by Ramos. Cross court off the block and down! Southland on the board via Vicky Aquino.
And that was one of those rallies that kind of kept me on the edge of my seat, even though we're standing up here. It kept me on my toes, Michael.
And that's kind of the play I expected to see, point after point after point, from these two high-quality teams here in this final match. Set by Reyes, and it's blocked at the net. They went with the little trickery, the short set, but Yarelis Perez Canedas, who is the statistical leader for this Southland team, was ready for it.
Now we have a 2-2 set on us.
A little bit of an awkward dig. Center Point can only push this one over. From the back row, Aquino. Nice one-hand dig by Bonanno. Back across it goes, off the block and out. And Central Point will pick up the tally. And it's all about taking advantage of the situation that you're put in, right? It's not always going to be perfect, but you have to read the play and react in order to make good judgment calls.
Yeah, and sometimes it's just about getting it over the net. It doesn't matter if it's pretty, doesn't matter if it's impressive, just get it over, keep the ball alive.
And you got to get it in bounds, which unfortunately Vicky Aquino did not do there. 4-2 now for the Tigers. Reyes to serve. Long forward set, barely creeps over the net. A little bit of an awkward one to handle. Returned to center by Canadas, and then blocked. Dug out by Figueroa. Figueroa gets it back from the set. It's blocked by Central Point, but it doesn't go over the net. Reyes back set. Middle. Another dig for Southland Christian. Aquino from the back line. Reyes again with the denial. Straight down the middle. Ramos. And that goes out of play.
That one touched by someone in the rafters up here, and Salvin wasn't too happy. Ref over there telling her, don't reach over, because that could have potentially been in play had it not, you know, gone over the rail.
Yeah, I think it might have gone over the rail, but you never know. And if somebody touches it, you see this in baseball all the time, too, at the professional level. You know, home runs being taken away or given by fans reaching out over the wall. Reverse set. Dug out. Set goes over the wall. Albiero freshly into the match for Central Point, and that one goes into the net.
And to that point, Michael, this is one of those sports where the environment actually is in play. So if it goes up in the rafters, that ball is still live. If it hits the rail and comes back down, that ball is technically still live.
Yeah, the lines on the court are only for the ball in and out of play when it touches the ground. The players can go anywhere they want as long as they get that ball over the net. 5-3 now for Central Point. White Tigers head coach Malvis Ortiz directing traffic. The libero Lopez to serve. Long set, tipped over, and unable to save it is Reyes, so Southland is right back in this one, only down one.
We talked about the amount of talent that both of these teams have, and usually before a game I'll talk to the coaches and I'll say, hey coach, give me a couple girls to look out for. And I asked Coach Ortiz that for Central Point, and she told me the whole team.
When your coach is that confident in you, it must inspire confidence in the team as well. I'm noticing in the last couple of points that Southland has been able to come back into this set that they've had more success on drop shots and off-speed hits than straight kill shots. And Central Point hasn't really been reacting to that defensively. They're expecting things to go power.
Like I said earlier, I love those little trick plays, and I think that they can be really beneficial to a team that maybe doesn't have as much height or as much power as this Central Point team does. So playing to their advantages is definitely something that's going to get Southland that win.
Phoebe Reyes does indeed have the power, and cross court for the kill it goes. 7-4 for the White Tigers. Here is Timaris Albiero serving for Central Point. Set straight up into the air. A little bit of improvisation from Aquino to dig it out. Cross court it goes. Olivo, that time the defense was there for Southland. It's got to go over with no kill attempt. Reyes straight up in the air and long it goes. A rare, rare kill mistake from Phoebe Reyes. And it's 7-5.
Another thing we talked about, the athleticism that's required to play this sport and be successful in this sport, and just knowing how hard you have to hit the ball and being able to just kind of place it exactly where you want it to go is something that obviously comes with experience and comes with practice, but it's just so impressive when these girls, 9 times out of 10, are able to just place the ball exactly where they intend it to go.
Nice little duck by Victoria Perez there. Just let the ball sail over her head and out of bounds. That's the other big thing you need in this sport. And all sports really, but volleyball particularly, is spatial awareness. You need to know where that out of bounds line is, and you need to know where you are in relation to it at all times, because you could let a ball go and get a point for not touching it.
Like we said earlier, that split second decision of whether or not to go for it being able to fine-tune your decision-making and tune into that spatial awareness.
Almirio. The set from Rodriguez. The kill is blocked at the net. Another chance for Southland. Backline kill attempt for Figueroa. Saved. Reyes across. Off the fingertips of Alonso and dug out by Southland. Tipped over the net. Reyes survives. Lopez plays it up. The kill is once again brought down by Figueroa. Off the block and out of bounds, and Southland continues to fight.
This has kind of been a you go, I go type of set, Michael. You take a point, I take a point. A bit different than we saw last set between these two teams.
The first set was defined by long runs. We saw the Southland one to open the set, and then the rest of the set was pretty much dominated by the Tigers.
But in this one, I don't think we've seen a lead bigger than three.
Reyes tips it over. Nice little improvisation. Excellent dig by Ramos on the side of Southland. Reyes, back set, blocked. The libero digs it out. Reyes cross court. Down. Another excellent dig by Southland. And an excellent shot over the middle. Played it to where nobody was. Valerie Rodriguez with the improvisation. And it's only a 1 point central point lead.
And what a rally that was. Impressive point for the Southland team.
Tipped over. Did that hit the line? No, it did not. And Southland ties the game. And exactly what we predicted earlier on. Southland, to get back in this game, is not going for the power. They're going for the placement. That time, Rodriguez couldn't save it. And it's 10-9 central point. Remember, best 2 out of 3 here in this SSAC volleyball tournament. So if central point does go on to win this set, this game is done. Southland trying to hang on and force a third and deciding set. Reyes with the dig. Set by Albiero. Deflected at the point of attack, kept alive by Perez. Over the net it goes from Perez Caneda. Reyes, short set, off the net, and saved! Ramos has to get this over, she does. How did that one stay in play? Reyes, behind her head, and did that touch the line? It went out of my view. No, it did not touch the line, and Southland has tied this one up.
That was a well-deserved point, Michael, able to make impressive saves multiple times in that rally.
And Valerie Rodriguez, who's playing middle right now, had probably one of the most impressive digs I've ever seen at the high school level. I thought that was a point for sure, and she was able to bring it up. And central point now with the receiving error and giving Southland their first lead of the set. You see head coach Alex Rivera for the Flames prowling the sideline. Power received, touched over. Reyes digs it out. Albiero to Olivo, blocked at the point of attack by Perez. Olivo has to get this one over. Ramos, and it's set over to Aquino. And she applies the finishing touch, 12-10. A little bit of a knuckleball serve that just drops right to the ground. And dropping right to the ground is KTL Alonso with that finish. And it's going to be a... Oh, they give a net touch violation against Alonso.
So now Southland able to not only take the lead, but stretch that lead to 3.
13-10, Flames over White Tigers. Reyes with the set right overhead. An impressive dig for Aquino.
I don't know what it is, but in the last couple of plays, this defense for the Southland team has really come into play.
Almost dug out by Rodriguez's foot. You are allowed to do that. Any part of your body is in play. But it did touch the ground, 13-11 Southland.
Yeah, this isn't soccer. You can use your hands and feet here.
Reyes cross court. Dug out by Rodriguez. Ramos, the set to the backside for Figueroa. Deflected back, saved by Reyes. Down it goes, off the block and through for a central point tally. Back to a 1 point game. And you said it right at the beginning of this set, Madison. I don't think either team is going to get away. We might be going down to the wire here.
And that's what makes it fun.
Figueroa tame over the net. Reyes short. Off the libero. Ramos and out. So it's a tie game again at 13. It's a game of runs, kind of like basketball. We saw Central Point with a big run early. Southland came back with a big run to take the lead now. The Tigers are back in it and have tied it up again. We'll take a timeout with the girls on the floor. This is VSN Orlando's production of SSAC Volleyball.
Searching for meaning in a relentless world. Always connected, but somehow alone. Trapped by illusion. We offer another path. Where the battle to belong begins. Awakened by a calling. United by the cause you fight for. No one can take away what it means to be among the few, the proud, the Marines.
Welcome back to the Varsity Sports Network, live from the Wingstop broadcast booth. I'm Madison Little, joined by Michael Trulio. And we are here in the battle for gold between the Central Point White Tigers and the Southland Christian Flames. And Michael, it is all tied up at 13 each.
13 apiece in the second set. Remember, Central Point leads 1-0. Nice cross-court kill right into the corner and down as the White Tigers, wearing green today, not white, take a 14-13 lead. And so Southland has made the adjustments that they've needed to get back into this game. They're not playing for power on the offensive side. They're controlling their passes more for placement. And Central Point, being as tall as they are, have struggled to adjust a little bit.
Yeah, and just a reminder for anyone just joining us, Central Point leads this match 1-0. And another reminder, best 2 out of 3 here, now expanding that lead to 2-15-13 here in the second set.
And something I've noticed as this tournament has gone on, players from the either eliminated teams or teams that are not currently playing are actually line judges, as we've seen players from both Bell Creek and Sebring as line judges for this match.
Yeah, and it's across all courts. I think we have a total of 8 courts in this one room, so a lot of volleyball going on. And when you have that many games going on, I think it's hard to find enough bodies to fill those spaces. So these girls come into it, even though they're technically done for the day, they know they have to serve their time on the line as well.
I mean, I'm a soccer referee, and I know the struggle all too well of trying to find people and schedule people for every game and make sure everything goes off without a hitch. So thank you to those players that have been eliminated or are on some downtime for stepping up and refereeing here.
Central Point able to get another kill right there, extending their lead 17-14, White Tigers.
And it seems that a different team is taking control out of every timeout. This time it's Central Point. From the back line it goes. Phoebe Reyes, the set. And it is in there, right on the line. Accuracy and power from Phoebe Reyes.
That's been the theme for the Central Point team, Michael.
It's a 4-point swing for the neon green and blue clad Central Point Tigers. It is 18-14 here in set number 2. Off the net, dug out by Reyes, and powered off the block and into the second level by Darlenis Olivo.
We got that ball up here at the broadcast booth.
I've been waiting all game. Like my reflexes are ready to like deflect the ball that's coming right at the camera because it could very well happen. 19-14, Central Point racing towards a potential gold medal here in Winter Haven. Drop shot dug out by Linares. Battle at the net won by Central Point. 5 points away.
They actually gave that one to Southland. I think they said it went off the hand of Central Point and went out of bounds, I think is what they're calling.
Either that or a net violation. Once again, we cannot really see the officials from where we are standing. Either way, it's a Southland Point, 19-15. Reyes sets. Olivo tips. Back it goes. Reyes behind her head. And a dig attempt by Rodriguez goes nowhere.
And now 5 points away from that gold medal for Central Point.
Substitution here for the White Tigers. Annalise Ortiz comes in, replacing Ana Maria Linares, who has been excellent at that outside hitter position on the right-hand side.
Yeah, Central Point has really been able to pull away since that last time out, but like we said earlier, this is one of those games where it's not over until it's over. Mm-hmm.
And again, if you get to 24 all, you have to win by two. So sets can, in theory, go on indefinitely. We saw a little bit of that in the U.S. Open earlier this week with a game that went something like 5 hours. A little bit of confusion going on the court. Southland to serve, down by four. Tournament life on the line right here. Reyes tries to send it over, just whiffs on it. Oh, no. She got the Southland touch. And it's 21-16. 4 points away. Cross-court pass, tipped over and down. Excellent finish. Deft touch by Vicky Aquino. I have been very impressed by her ability to read the floor and read the defense.
Central Point keeping their lead comfortable, but Southland is not giving up. It's been kind of one of those you get a point, I get a point situations here, but fortunately for them, Central Point has a pretty comfortable lead right now.
Reyes. Oh, what a recovery off the block by Reyes. Ramos on the setup for Aquino. Dug out by Olivo. Reyes cross court. Phoebe Reyes. Recovery by Southland. Back row hit. Down it goes. Dug out by Lopez. Ramos across. Set one. Set two. Again denied at the net. This rally has gone on for five consecutive. Make that six consecutive passes. And off the wall. That is going to be out of play. And Central Point moves to within three. Timeout on the floor. Will we see the crowning moment for the White Tigers coming up next? Stick around to find out. This is Varsity Sports Network's production of SSAC Volleyball.
And welcome back to the Varsity Sports Network SSAC Volleyball Invitational, live from the Wingstop broadcast booth here at the Advent Health Fieldhouse in Winter Haven, Florida. Once again, I'm Madison Little, joined by the fabulous Michael Trulio from VSN Daytona's channel. He came down to hang out and do some volleyball with me today. We greatly appreciate you coming down once again. Right now, we are in the last couple points of what could be the championship match for this Central Point team. They are leading right now 22-17 over the Southland Christian Flames.
Got to get to 25 in this second set. Already a one set to love lead. Tough recovery. Ramos plays it over with her forearms. Reyes cross court. Oh, that's a little bit of a mistake, but it was able to be recovered by Phoebe Reyes. Now Reyes again to Phoebe. Long, and Southland recovers. 22-18. It's not over yet. But Central Point surely in the driver's seat from this position.
Not over till it's over.
Rodriguez sends it across. Reyes just taps it over, and a nice little improvisation from the setter to give the White Tigers almost match point. The libero goes out, replaced by Ana Maria Linares, number four on the front line. And the serve goes into the net. As magnificent as Maureen Reyes has been setting the ball, she has two service aces on the match.
Yeah, that's pretty impressive how...
Service errors, not service aces.
Pretty impressive how much she's able to contribute. But, you know, these players all have their weaknesses and strengths, and I don't know if I would necessarily say her serving's a weakness, because it's definitely not, but definitely more consistent in other aspects of the game.
Played down the middle by Linares, and we have reached match point. Championship gold medal point for Central Point. 24-19 in this second set. Dug out by Southland. Over the net it goes. Phoebe Reyes to Maureen Reyes, and that one finds the back corner, and this ball game is over. Tournament over. Central Point is the Sunshine State Athletic Conference Blue Division champion.
They were able to take that one in two, giving Southland their first loss of their season, Michael. First loss of the tournament, but even bigger than that, first loss of their season. So Central Point definitely able to come out and dominate in both sets. It was a little bit back and forth there for a while, but ultimately Central Point able to pull away, get that win, and go home with the gold today.
There was a moment in the second set where I thought, oh, Southland's coming back in it. They had about an 8-point swing in the middle of the second set. They took the 5-point lead, but from there, Central Point called a timeout. They got their heads together, and they were able to run the table in the rest of the second set and take this one in straight sets. I have no doubt we will see both of these teams back at the SSAC finals at the end of the season.
Yeah, definitely a long weekend for these girls. Like you said, this was their seventh or eighth match of the weekend, so 48 hours, seven volleyball matches. Long weekend. They'll go home, get some well-deserved rest. Central Point going home, one gold medal stronger.
Yeah, and I would expect them to have inside track to this SSAC state tournaments at the end of the season. But, you know, the other teams we've seen today as well, Bell Creek and Sebring, I expect them to favor prominently in either SSAC or FHSAA play going down the stretch.
And, Michael, great volleyball today. And once again, we appreciate you coming down to the VSN Orlando channel for the weekend. Great day of volleyball. More to come from Varsity Sports Network in this upcoming week. We have football, volleyball, and a few other things coming out, I think, this week. So that's it for us today. I'm Madison Little, joined once again by Michael Trulio on the Varsity Sports Network.
Hi, I'm Kevin Harrington, an original shark from Shark Tank. Protect your ankles with Prevent Sprain socks.
In sports, we wear all types of equipment to protect ourselves from injury. We use helmets, mouth guards, shoulder pads, chest protectors, and knee, elbow, and shin pads for protection and prevention. One of the most important, yet neglected parts of the body are the ankles.
Research shows that more than 30% of all sports injuries are ankle-related, and 62% of all ankle sprains happen during practice and training. Just think about it. Very few sports can be played with an ankle injury, and it can take 1 to 3 weeks to heal, sometimes months to get back to full strength and mobility. Preventing an injury is key in any sport and applies to any job where you're on your feet all day as well.
Prevent Sprain socks were scientifically designed and engineered for support, stability, and performance.
Stay active with PreventSprainSocks.com.
For every generation, it has started with the call to serve. Discovering the purpose and the belonging earned with the title. Learning to dig deep and push through adversity together. Defending our nation and its people. It is a life of great worth and reward. But Marines are never really finished serving. Their commitment comes full circle, visible in communities across our country. This is Semper Fidelis, always faithful. Always Marine, marking a path for the next generation.
What's up, sports fans? This is Bobby Allen, broadcaster for the Varsity Sports Network, and I'm here to tell you about an incredible opportunity that your business can advertise with us on the only 24/7 high school sports network. We can base any package around your budget or advertising needs, and it is unparalleled in comparison to other opportunities out there. We cover every inch of the Sunshine State with 16 channels of varsity sports coverage. Come join us in supporting these student athletes, local schools, and the local communities. Email us today at sports@varsitysportsnetwork.org or call the number below on your screen to find out how we can help you market and promote your business in the best possible way. Again, I'm Bobby Allen with the Varsity Sports Network, and we are the home of high school sports in Florida.
In In sports, we wear all types of equipment to protect ourselves from injury. One of the most important, yet neglected parts of the body are the ankles.
Research shows that more than 30% of all sports injuries are ankle-related. Preventing an injury is key in any sport and applies to any job where you're on your feet all day as well.
Prevent Sprain socks were scientifically designed and engineered for support, stability, and performance.
Stay active with PreventSprainSocks.com.